بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
Jews, come to the masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And they said, we have some questions that cannot be answered except by a prophet or a true successor of a prophet, a divine successor of the prophet. This was, of course, after the prophet's death. They came, they asked around, who's the Khalifa? They said, so-and-so is the Khalifa. They came to the Khalifa. They asked him the questions, he couldn't answer. So they said, what is this religion? You know, is this your Khalifa? Then Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam came and they told him, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, we have some people here who have some questions. He said, come and ask me. They said, we asked your Khalifa already. He said, no, ask me. They said, we have some questions that cannot be answered by anyone except a prophet or a true successor to a prophet. He said, ask me. They said, can you tell us about a piece of land that never saw the sun except once in its lifetime and it will never see the sun again? He said, yes, that is the land of the Red Sea when Musa alayhi salam parted the sea. When the sea parted, that land saw the sun for that one time and it will never see the sun again. That's it. They said, can you tell us about a grave that is moving, a mobile grave? He said, yes, that was the whale that ate Yunus alayhi salam. That whale, Allah says in the Quran, that if Yunus was not among the musabbihin, that if he had not done tasbih, سبحانك لا إله إلا أنت إني كنت من الظالمين فاستجبنا له ونجيناه من الغم. If he had not said this tasbih, if he had not done this dua, this prayer, Allah states in the Quran, he would have remained in him, this whale, until the day of judgment. This khalas would have become his grave. But because of his tasbih, Allah saved him. So he said, that grave is a mobile grave. It's a moving grave. It would be the grave of Yunus alayhi salam. They said, can you tell us about five that came into the world without a mother? No mother. He said, Adam alayhi salam. One. Two, Hawa alayhi salam. Three, the sheep that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala presented to Ibrahim to sacrifice instead of Ismail alayhi salam. That sheep came from Allah, didn't come from a mother. Four, the camel of Salih alayhi salam. That camel did not come from a mother. And five, it is what? The snake of Musa alayhi salam. The snake of Musa didn't come from a mother. And some say another hadith as well. He added a sixth one, referring to the six, not five, and that is Iblis. Iblis also did not have a mother as well. But nonetheless, they said, tell us, what is the meaning of number one? He replied, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ. Allah is one. They said, what is the meaning of number two? Define two. He said, Adam and Hawa, without whom there would be no humanity. They are the fathers of the humanity, or the father and the mother of the humanity. They said, what is the meaning of number three? He said, these are the three close angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Jibra'il, Mika'il, and Israfil. So those three angels are the close angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have a higher rank among the angels. Those are the three. They said, what is the meaning of four? He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent four holy books, at Tawrat, والإنجيل والزبور والقرآن. That's four. He said, what is the meaning of number five? He said, there are five times of the Salat. There are five times of the daily prayers. They said, what is the meaning of number six? He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heavens and the earth in 6 days. In 6 days. في ستة أيام. Or six stages, depending how you translate or how you interpret the ayah. They said, what is the meaning of number seven? He said, وَجَعَلْنَا فَوْقَهُمْ سَبْعًا شِدَادًا وَخَلَقْنَا فَوْقَهُمْ سَبْعًا شِدَادًا. That we created different verses in the Quran. They say that we created seven skies, that there are seven skies. They said, what is the meaning of number eight? قَالُ وَيَحْمِلُونَ عَرْشَ رَبِّهِمْ فَوْقَهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ ثَمَانِيَةً. That eight angels would carry the commands of Allah. Or the ayah says the throne of Allah, but it's the command of Allah on the day of judgment. Eight. They said, what is the meaning of number nine? He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Musa alayhi salam nine signs, tis'a ayat, according to the Quran. Nine signs. They said, what is the meaning of ten? He said, these were the 10 extra days that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made Musa remain in addition to the 30 days that he was promised. وَأَتْمَمْنَاهَا بِعَشْرٍ. 10 more days were added. These are the days. They said, what about 11? He said, these were the brothers of Yusuf alayhi salam. And 12, he said, these were the number of tribes in the children of Israel. And they are the number of the successors of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam. They asked him, they said, who are you? قال أنا علي بن أبي طالب. And I am the one who's mentioned in your books as Ilya. That is me. They said, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله وأنك بالحق وصي رسول الله. Indeed, you are a successor of the Prophet. That is the ilm of Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullahi alayhi. He had knowledge of things that were discovered centuries later. He had knowledge of understanding and answering questions where people did not answer or were unable to answer. That is the ilm of Adam.
Yeah, who's there?